Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
NASCAR goes racing under the lights this week at Richmond, Virginia. Raceline looks at this week's race through the eyes of four-time champ Jeff Gordon. Denny Hamlin is in his home state this week, and his team has done well with the car of tomorrow. FedEx crew chief Mike Ford joins Joe this week to talk about their chances. Those stories, our weekly fans forum, Mary Scully's point of view, and this week in Team Ford Racing, all next on Raceline. Brought to you by Mechanics Wear, the number one glove in NASCAR, and by Ford. Bold moves, they happen every day.
NASCAR goes from the Super Speedway to a short track this week, and the Hendrick bandwagon rolls on. Hi, everybody, I'm Joe Moore. Welcome to this week's edition of Raceline. Hendrick Motorsports still red hot in 2007. Now they've won six of the first nine races of this 2007 season with Jeff Gordon's win this past week at Talladega Super Speedway. What he did at Talladega was more than just win for the fifth time for him at Talladega and give Hendrick their sixth win of the year. He also took sole possession of sixth on the all-time win list, passing the late Dale Earnhardt. Now, with seven more wins, he'll equal Cale Yarborough at 83. Another one, and then he'll join the tie between Darrell Waltrip and Bobby Allison. They each have 84 wins. From there, it's a big jump to David Pearson at 105, and Jeff says he doubts he'll ever get there.
I guarantee I won't be passing David Pearson, 105. No, I hope that I can get above my average, you know, and win some more races. I would love to do that, but... you know, I know that I don't plan on racing until, you know, I'm 45.
And Jeff could easily tie his teammate Jimmy Johnson for three wins in 2007 on Saturday night at Richmond, Virginia.
I always go back and forth between here and Michigan. This is definitely one of my favorites. I like Michigan as well. I feel like Michigan is a 2 mile in length Richmond, so that's probably why I like both of them. It's a great racetrack, you know, multiple grooves. It's fast, but yet still has a short track quality to it. Any track we go to where there's more than one groove to run around the track, I like it. And you know, that, you know, as far as short tracks go, Richmond is the only track out there really that has multiple grooves.
But Jeff isn't the only driver who likes Richmond. Just about everybody does, particularly young Denny Hamlin, whose home is nearby Chesterfield, Virginia. Racing on the home track, that's going to be a very important one for the FedEx team. Mike Ford is crew chief for Denny Hamlin in the Joe Gibbs Racing operation at the FedEx Chevy. He joins us this week here on Raceline. Mike, I know you guys put a lot of importance on every single race, every chance to win, but how much more important is it for Denny going to his home track?
Well, you know, obviously... Denny's very passionate about his home track in Richmond and has a lot of family and friends there, and he gets more excited about that race than any other, I think. And last year we had a couple good runs. We finished second in the spring race and sat on the pole in the fall race, and we feel like we've got a really strong package with the car of tomorrow. We're looking forward to it. We think this can be our breakout week. We've had four or five good weeks with a shot at winning each week, and you know, hopefully we can break through at Richmond.
Denny was second in this race last year, and you guys have proven you're good with that Car of Tomorrow program. How good do you feel about Saturday night?
We feel really confident about this week. We feel like, you know, obviously last fall we sat on the pole and we had issues during the race with, you know, melted spark plug wire. Had a shot at winning the first race last year, and we feel like we're ready to win a race here.
Thanks, Mike. More with you coming up later today on Raceline. Mike Ford, crew chief for the FedEx Chevy of driver Denny Hamlin. Now, before we go to break, let's check our in-the-hole scoreboard after the running of the Aaron's 499 at Talladega Super Speedway. The hole continues to get deeper for Michael Waltrip. He missed the race this past weekend. He and teammate Dale Jarrett, who made the race, but DJ used his last champion's provisional. He'll be struggling this week at Richmond and from here on out. Both Brian Vickers and A.J. Allmendinger missed the Talladega event, going even further into the hole for Red Bull Racing. Casey Mears is still back there in 35th. Scott Riggs moved up a spot, but he's only in 36th. Casey Kane gained two spots. He's now up to 31st. And rookie David Reagan moved up two positions. He's now in 26th.
Still to go today on Raceline, Mike Ford talks about the FedEx Team's Car of Tomorrow program. And controversy does make a difference to a race team. First, here's a look at the championship points on this week's Mechanics Wear scoreboard. Stay up to date on the latest NASCAR news with Joe on NASCAR Today. Check your listings for the MRN station near you. More of today's show right after this. On race day and every day, wear the tool that fits like a glove. Available at auto parts stores, Lowe's stores, and online at mechanics.com.
Welcome back to Raceline this week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo with a look at this week's news. Well, one of the biggest stories circulating around the garage area at Talladega was about DEI possibly buying Robert Yates Racing. Evidently, Doug Yates has told people that there have been preliminary talks, so there must be something to the story. Apparently, Doug Yates wants to concentrate more on building engines for Ford teams and not so much on the management day-to-day of that race team. Now, they say they will, Robert Yates, stay with Ford if a purchase does occur, but you have to wonder, since DEI is very obviously in the Chevrolet camp for the long haul. Well, last week was not a good one for Tony Stewart. After blasting NASCAR on his radio show, Stewart was fined for failing to appear at the post-race press conference at Phoenix. Then at Talladega, a sure top five, maybe even a win, went out the window when he got caught up in a crash during the green-white checkered finish. Well, those are just some of the big stories swirling around the garage area. That, all the controversy going on with DEI, will Dale Jr. be back there, and Michael Waltrip's continuing saga. What is going on down in Charlotte with all this stuff going on? Let's go down to Steve Post now. Steve, what is the effect on these guys working in these shops every day, all these rumors flying around, all the gossip going on? How does this affect these guys in trying to get their job done on a day-to-day basis?
And Tiffany, you have to wonder what that means for the guys in the trenches, but you have three different stories happening here. Tony Stewart and all of the swirl around him, those guys have been through it before. They've seen this with Tony, and it doesn't seem to faze them at all. Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s team, it hasn't fazed them yet. Their performance has still been well on the Budweiser Chevy team, but I do wonder when it becomes a distraction for that team, because it does involve their jobs and their livelihoods. Now, looking at the Michael Waltrip struggle and the Toyota situation, that is performance-based. And Michael has talked about his teams, his crew guys, being in there rock solid, being right on board with it, being up on the wheel, being ready to go. But you just have to wonder, in the trenches as they are, you know they're working hard. It's not a matter of working hard, but so little progress, you do wonder how the crew guys are handling it headed home on Friday night on most of these race weekends. And it is tough when they know all their buddies are still racing come Sunday afternoon.
Thanks a lot, Steve. Now, we reported here a few weeks ago that a lot of team owners are interested in not phasing in the car of tomorrow next year, but moving to it full time. NASCAR is looking at the possibility. They did a kind of survey of team owners, and 80% of them, at last count, are interested in going ahead and moving full-time to the car of tomorrow next year rather than in 2009. They say it costs twice as much to keep producing two kinds of cars for different racetracks. Well, that's it for the news this week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo. More Raceline coming up right after this.
Male enhancement. 5 years ago, few believed that this simple capsule could make a man larger. There was a lot of skepticism that a simple capsule could do such an amazing thing. A capsule that can make a man larger? But now, 5 years later, Extends has sold over 100 million capsules to men of all ages all over the world.
That's because the key ingredient in Extends has been scientifically proven to increase the size of that certain part of the male body. It's not a gimmick. It's real science. Now with over 100 million Extends capsules taken by men, it's hard to be skeptical. Extends was designed to do only one thing, make you larger regardless of age.
We're so sure Extends will make you larger, we're going to give you a week's supply absolutely free. All you pay for is the postage stamp.
A week's supply of Extends for the cost of a postage stamp. If Extends didn't do something pretty amazing, could we afford to do this? Call now for your free week's supply of Extends. You have nothing to lose, but a lot to gain.
Welcome back to Raceline this week. The Aaron's 499 was the ninth race of the 2007 season. That gives us now 17 before the championship series begins. So, after race number 9, let's check the chase. The chase contenders are about the same this week as last, with the exception of Mark Martin, who fell out of the top 12 since he didn't run Talladega. Jamie McMurray made the biggest jump, going from 12th to a much more comfortable spot at 7th. Kevin Harvick moved up one spot, and Kurt Busch, too, their 9th and 10th, respectively. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is 14th, now just 10 points out of the chase window. Jeff Gordon leads by 203 over Jeff Burton going to Richmond. Checking over the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, young Eric Darnell reached a milestone this past weekend, actually last weekend, as he won the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series race at the Kansas Speedway. Darnell drives for Roush Fenway Racing. He's one of those driver development guys coming up very similar to the way Greg Biffle did and the way that Jack Roush brought up Kurt Busch. He eventually will be in the Busch Series and the Nextel Cup Series. Congratulations to Eric Darnell.
This week in Team Ford Racing is brought to you by Ford. Bold moves.
Jack Roush is the lead man for Ford Motor Company in NASCAR racing. He currently fields 5 Nextel Cup cars, several Busch teams, and is coming off a win last week, as we told you, in the Truck Series with young Eric Darnell. Jack has been a Ford man for nearly all of his life, dating back to even before when he worked for the company.
Yeah, I had two job interviews when I graduated from college at Berea, Kentucky in 1964. One was with Ford Motor Company and the other was with the U.S. Air Force. And my background was strong in mathematics and physics coming out of Berea. And the Air Force decided they would like for me to be a WISO, a navigator and an ordnance guy in the back seat of an F-4, which had it was a two-man crewed airplane. And of course, I was only interested in flying the thing. So I decided not to be a WISO, that I would take the offer that I had from Ford Motor Company. Of course, I was equally interested in cars and trucks. By the time I was 22 years old, I'd already put 4 big honking V8 engines and little bitty cars that had 6-cylinder engines that I put together out of junkyard parts that I was driving on the street. And of course, I put one together and enjoy it. And now I see how I could build a better one, and so I'd sell that one. I'd do the next one. So, cars and trucks and the challenges that go with making them work ideally for different circumstances had always been a great challenge for me, and something that I could see myself being interested in for all my life. And of course, years later, here I stand.
Find out more of what's going on in Ford Racing and join the fun at Team Ford Racing. Find out more at FordRacing.com. More of today's show right after this.
There are 3 lines in drag racing: the start line, the finish line, and the line that separates sanity from crazy, good from bad, winners from losers. Do you have what it takes to cross the line into a sport so powerful that it makes your eyes water and your bones rattle?
May 18th through 20th, the NHRA returns to Bristol Dragway for the O'Reilly Thunder Valley Nationals, presented by Q. NHRA Power 8 Drag Racing. Experience the power.
Cross the line at Thunder Valley.
They call it a racetrack, a raceway, a speedway. It's an arena.
I saw a guy named Bill win a million.
I saw the kid win four straight 500s. I saw the closest finish in NASCAR history. I've seen them all. Earnhardt, Pearson, Yarborough. Stock car legends. They all crossed right here, this line. Tickets are on sale now for the Dodge Avenger 500 weekend, May 11th and 12th. Call 866-459-RACE or visit racetickets.com. Darlington, too tough to tame.
Back on Raceline, one of the fun parts of this show is telling you when we're giving away race tickets. And we're doing it again, this time for the Diamond Hill Plywood 200 Bush Race at Darlington next week and the Dodge Avenger 500. Congratulations to Mary Petsky of Marble, North Carolina, Alan Gilstrap of Liberty, South Carolina, Sabrina Johnston of Reidsville, North Carolina, and Jeremy Thomas of Covington, Virginia. We'll be seeing you guys at Darlington next week. Hey, want to see some great drag racing? This is some of the very best. The NHRA O'Reilly Thunder Valley Nationals at Bristol Dragway coming up in just 2 weeks. Go to our website and enter to win. If you can't wait to win, you can buy your tickets online at bristoldragway.com. NASCAR is in Richmond, Virginia on Saturday night. It's a Crown Royal presents the Jim Stewart 400. If you're wondering who Jim Stewart is, he won a contest put on by Crown Royal last year. And the prize was to have the race named for him, hence the Jim Stewart 400. Now, Dale Earnhardt Jr. doesn't have a race named for him, but he's looking at his first win for the 2007 season. And remember, Jr. won this race last year.
Yeah, it was fun. We had a good car. The 29 was fast all night, and they had some troubles, some bad pit strategy or whatever, made some mistakes not pitting when they should have, but... That seems to be what the short track racing is all about. All the cars are so evenly matched. They're running toward the front. It's really more about pit strategy and who can get out first on that last stop and try to maintain that position, and that's what we're able to do.
Now let's see what Mary Scully's thinking about this week on our Racing Milestones Point of View.
Wow, did I hear from you fans following my remarks about James Hilton's attempt to make the Daytona 500. My email box was scorched with angry letters. For those who didn't hear my point of view that week, I said that the Daytona 500 is not just any race, that it is the equivalent of the Super Bowl, where only the best of the best should be playing or driving. I had no axe to grind against James Hilton personally. I don't believe any 72-year-old driver should drive in Nextel Cup, much less in the Daytona 500. I also noted that Hilton had not raced in a Cup Series event in many years, and that his best finish at Daytona was a third in his heyday 40 years ago in 1967. David Hunkin of Lexington, Virginia, wrote that I hadn't done my research because I didn't mention that Hilton had won a Talladega 500. That's true, he did, back in 1972. 35 years ago. If you recall, when Richard Petty retired in 1992 at age 55, he said he had stayed too long in the game. Do you remember DW's last few years? He was always at the back of the pack. I stand by my opinion that only drivers in top physical condition belong in Nextel Cup racing, and that does not include drivers in their 70s. I'm Mary Scully, editor of Racing Milestones magazine. My point of view is brought to you by SportsGearRacing.com.
The most prized collectibles fans could own are fire suits or helmets actually worn in a race by their favorite driver. Learn all about used race clothes in this month's issue of Racing Milestones, America's race fan magazine. Now on sale at Auto Trader Racks in gas, marts, and convenience stores nationwide.
Last week's fans forum question on Raceline was, which team is the best in NASCAR right now? Here's the one we chose as this week's winner. Pamela Oaks of Seneca, South Carolina says, I think the Hendrick team is doing great this year. All four teams are working together and sharing information that helps the entire Hendrick team, not individual drivers. Jeff, Jimmy, and Kyle have had great finishes this year. Unfortunately, Casey Mears is not doing so well, but they'll get their act together. Mears just needs to adjust to the new team, and he'll be all right. So, Pamela, I think that's pretty obvious. But anyway, we're going to send you our Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Now, this week's question. What do you think of Tony Stewart's statements last week criticizing NASCAR?
Answer this week's Fans Forum question and we'll send you a great Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Just go to our website at racelineonline.com. More of today's show right after this.
Own a timeshare or campground membership? Turn it into cash.
Timeshares Only got us our full asking price before our next monthly payment was due.
Timeshares Only is the nation's largest, number one, most successful timeshare agency, representing properties from the biggest names in the industry.
No one sells more timeshares.
Call now and receive a free information kit, including 10 secrets to timeshares. You owe it to yourself to work with the best.
Don't delay. Call 1-800-421-0598.
There are three lines in drag racing. The start line, the finish line, and the line that separates sanity from crazy, good from bad, winners from losers. Do you have what it takes to cross the line into a sport so powerful that it makes your eyes water and your bones rattle?
May 18th through 20th, the NHRA returns to Bristol Dragway for the O'Reilly Thunder Valley Nationals, presented by Q. NHRA Power 8 Drag Racing. Experience the power.
Cross the line at Thunder Valley.
We're back on this week's edition of Raceline. Welcome back, Mike Ford, crew chief for the FedEx Chevy, of driver Denny Hamlin down at Joe Gibbs Racing. Mike, again, thanks for joining us here today. You've got to feel pretty good about the way your year has gone so far. You guys nearly pulled off a win at Phoenix, although you got a speeding ticket on pit road that kind of took you out of the box. That late race caution last week at Talladega took you out of a possibility, fuel-wise, to win the race there. So although you've not won, it must make you feel pretty good knowing you guys have run that well.
Yeah, obviously we're having shots at winning these races. We've made some mistakes that we're keying on to fix, and you know, feel like through the summer months we're gonna look at trying to peak. We don't feel like we've peaked yet. We've run extremely well. I think we've got better finishes at every race so far, other than one race at Texas, and we still got a top 10 there than what we got a year ago. So our performance is definitely better. No, we haven't won a race yet, but we've been in contention. And, you know, at this level, you ask for a shot to be able to win the race, and we've had that several times. And it's just a matter of time. Hopefully this week at Richmond we can break through and get into victory lane. But Car of Tomorrow has been very good for us. So we're looking at keeping that program moving and improving the intermediates along the way. And, you know, hopefully put ourselves in a strong position come, you know, the two-thirds mark of the season, and make a strong run for this championship.
The FedEx team is currently fifth in the championship point standings, so you're very comfortably in the chase, although that's a long way off. But how much do you keep up with where you are in the points, and do you monitor that even during the running of a race?
We're not tracking it race to race right now. We're going out. You still have to run these races with, you know, taking a shot to win, and you know, that's why you race. You race to win, and we're trying to put ourselves in position to win races. And you know, the points will take care of themselves if you do that. So we're evaluating what we have as a program right now, and improving each package just a little bit, and hopefully make a stronger team, more consistent week to week with taking a shot at winning, not just at the short tracks, but the intermediates and speedways as well.
Mike, thanks again for joining us on Raceline, and good luck Saturday night at Richmond. Now, Denny Hamlin was second in this race last year. In the fall race at Richmond, he was 15th, so can I sell you on some Denny Hamlin?
Joe, you absolutely can sell me some Denny Hamlin. I'm going to go with him this week. With the way he's been running on short tracks this year, and with the runner-up finish last year, I think he is definitely going to win at this track. That battle with he and Junior last year was just phenomenal. But I think Denny is going to come out on top this time and finally win at Richmond.
All right, one vote in for Denny Hamlin. Mike, you went out on a limb last week and it paid off. Well, almost did anyway. You going to do that again?
Well, no, I'm not going to go out on a limb, but I guess there's some people out there that might think that I am going out on a limb, and that's because I'm going to go with Tony Stewart. I know I keep going back to him, but there's two things about him. One, when he's mad, he seems to win races. But unfortunately this year, if it weren't for bad luck, Tony Stewart wouldn't have any luck at all, but I think that luck is about ready to turn around. I think we're going to see him in victory lane, climbing the fence to start finish line at Richmond.
I knew you'd go back to Tony Stewart eventually. I'm going to go back to Dale Earnhardt Jr. He's a three-time winner at Richmond. He was very good in the test they had there several weeks ago, and their Car of Tomorrow program is coming on strong. I think Jr. is going to do it at Richmond on Saturday night. Last week, the three of us were all in the top four in the finish at Talladega. Hopefully, we'll do that good again this week. Our picks: Dale Earnhardt Jr., Tony Stewart, or Denny Hamlin to win. Thanks again for watching Raceline. We'll see you here next week.
Raceline is brought to you by Mechanicswear, the number one glove in NASCAR.
by Ford. Bold moves. Also by MRN Radio, the voice of NASCAR. And by Fast Track, the weekly NASCAR news leader. Find out more about our sponsors and contact us at the Raceline website at racelineonline.com. Watch past editions of Raceline anytime on the World Wide Web. Just go to racelineonline.com and link to the Auto Channel. Closed captioning on Raceline provided by Racing Milestones.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.